Have you ever heard of the Akashic Records? I've heard it said that it's like a library in the spiritual world that provides some insights into our soul's purpose, mission. It can help us with daily problems and challenges, but really directs us toward living the life that most grows our soul. Well, I know relatively little about it, but that's why I'm excited today to be talking with Anne Marie Pizarro, and she is an expert on the Akashic Records. I'm going to read you her bio, and then I'll bring her on, and it's going to be a fascinating conversation. All right, so Anne Marie is a holistic practitioner, a multi-preneur, and an Akashic Record practitioner. She works with clients all over the world in the Akashic Records and the human energy field to help them receive answers, information, and tools for their pressing questions and needs. Anne, great to have you here. Thanks for joining me for this.
Thanks, George. And I'm really happy to be here. I'm really excited to share this knowledge with the world. So
yeah,
thank you for having me.
Absolutely. So I'll start off, and you can, of course, share as much as you'd like, but I'd love to start off with just your definition of the Akashic Records. What is that?
Oh, wow. Well, you know, in the Bible, they talk about the Akashic Records, like the Book of Life. And Edgar Cayce refers to the Akashic Records like the supercomputer. I, loving both technology and information, feel like it's really a fusion of both. And I feel like the Akashic Records is this field of energy that surrounds us at all times. And when we are in different time frames, different civilizations, they really reflect where we're at in that time. So when we have this technology right now that's exploding in growth around us, I feel like the records also holds that information that meets us where we're at in our lives. So I feel like not only is this a library, it's really like a tool that we have access to be able to help us.
Mm. And what kinds of issues does the Akashic Records help us with?
Well, you know, honestly, it really helps all different aspects of life. We work with not only physical situations such as health issues, what could be the causes and blockages of those, root causes, and some of those even come from past life karma. So we look at physical conditions, emotional circumstances, mental things that may be going on, as well as spiritual. When we look at that in terms of the energy field, we are really looking at how we as human beings function in life. So when we work in the Akashic Records, we can get information that influences our relationships, our patterns, the way we think, the way we eat, the way we operate as business owners, the way we operate as people. Some of these things are encoded in our beings because this is part of our biographical expression in the Akashic Records.
And speaking of business owners, that's one of the things that you offer, which we'll talk about in more depth later, but you help business owners tap into what you call their business council.
Right. Primarily, when I started working in the Akashic Records, I was working as a nurse, and I was drawn into this field of work because I was just so fascinated by the information that I was getting. And then I was already an entrepreneur by nature. I started very young at an early age, and as I started to wrap my head around business, the records really directed some of my passions and my influences to the point where I sometimes started more businesses than I could handle because the records had all this information available to me. So whatever I asked was available. Sometimes I didn't ask the right questions like, is this too much? Are there limitations here? And so the records really showed me the information that would help me grow these businesses. And why I'm really passionate about working with business owners is because I feel like we as small business owners are here to make an impact, a mark in the world. And part of that mark in the world is tied to the contracts that we have in the Akashic Records around service, around learning, around soul development, around self-love. And so business is really the playground, the platform for us to really test, experience, and serve the world through our offers and helps us really step into our power.
Wow, that's great. And just so people have a sense of how it works, how does one tap into the Akashic Records. I mean, it's not something most of us can physically see. It's not something we can access through the internet. So how does it happen?
Yeah. Well, you know, what's fascinating, George, is that in the 12 plus years that I've been doing the Akashic Records and reading the records, I get an Akashic Record reading from different people every year, because I like to do that research study on my own to see how do other people read the records. And there are so many different ways, and there are books that are out as well as methods that are released. And so there are many ways to get into the Akashic Records, including, say, theta healing. You can be in this altered theta state and you can enter the Akashic Records. For some people, they like to read a prayer to access into the Akashic Records. And I'd like to ask you to think of the Akashic Records like a big building with multiple doors. And so when I enter the Akashic Records with people, I take them to a specific room. And in that room, we are greeted by their record keepers, their counsel, all the beings that are really working with them at this time to help answer their questions. We don't actually walk around the records, the Akashic Records, pulling out books to answer these questions, because a lot of these books we may not even need. And so when we enter the Akashic Records a specific way, a specific method, then we're really able to harness information directly for what we need at that time. So it's a very purposeful reason for coming in. So people can access the records through channeling, through meditation, through reading a prayer. Sometimes the Akashic Records opens to people in dreams, ideas, thoughts just show up, and connections with people show up. And some of that feels like it's orchestrated. And in truth, some of it is orchestrated by your guides and your counsel for certain meetings to happen.
Wow. And how does... there's a lot we could talk about, but I'm curious, let's get into this idea of free will versus what's already written. So if I understand correctly, the Akashic Records contains information not just about our past lives, which can be rich in insight, but even our future lives. Is that right? And it kind of provides a blueprint for our, like you said, the soul's development. And just so you know, I mean, my spiritual perspective includes learning from like near-death experiences and things like that. And I think in some NDEs, near-death experiences, people have visited the Akashic Records, and et cetera, like a spirit, like a physical spiritual building, you know, that they see in the spiritual world, or just like you're describing. But so how does free will and this kind of blueprint idea play in?
Yeah, well, I think the best analogy is to imagine you are on a road trip as a soul, and you're going on a very long road trip. And let's say, for example, you're driving from Los Angeles to New York, and that's a very long road. That's a lot of states that you're going to pass through. You're going to pass through a lot of attractions. And that's exactly what working in the Akashic Records and living this life is every moment of the day, you are exercising your free will. You are choosing every moment, even what kind of thoughts you want to pay attention to, how you want to feel when you wake up, whether you want to initiate an action. And when doubt shows up, those are the things that also triggers your free will to either feed it or choose something else. So free will is a gift, I would say, that you were given in this life to really exercise your boundaries in the Akashic Records. As a matter of fact, when you think about it, if you're pulling off the freeway, and you're going to go see an attraction, and you're looking at this beautiful sight, and there's mountains everywhere, and there's a railing there. Now, free will is stopping you from driving past that railing to your death. And that's the opportunity every time, every day, and every moment that you're exerting that influences what shows up and appears in the Akashic Records. So when we open the Akashic Records, you're getting a snapshot of time. Between point A and point B, when you reopen your Akashic Records the second time, your free will is exercising between point A and point B all these different choices. How often you're going to switch, course correct, change directions. So free will is really your choice to be able to grow as a soul versus devolve. I like to call that devolve.
Wow. And as a soul, we come here, there is certain things that maybe we designed or hoped to accomplish, and that often has to do with other souls. So what's your perspective on kind of soul contracts, agreements? How does that relate to the Akashic Records?
You know, one of the reasons why I got interested in doing the Akashic Records was I heard a story, and this was the story that invited me into the Akashic Records. And it was a soul story that I heard about my past life and my ex-husband's past life and how we were connected at that time to deliver this being down, who in this time is known as our daughter. So what I find about this this aspect of contracts is that contracts are part of the agreements that we make in this lifetime for our souls to experience certain lessons to evolve in certain aspects of ourselves. And so when we have these contractual agreements, whether they're really big contracts like relationships versus small contracts, your neighbor, somebody that you meet on the street, how you interact with a coworker, those kind of contracts define the smaller aspects of your nature, which eventually feed into the bigger aspect of yourself, how you think of yourself, how you relate to the world. So in a way, these contracts are defined by certain stages you have in life too. When you are able to resolve a contract and step into a new path, this usually opens a new door of growth. For a lot of people, when they've completed contracts in relationships, in working environments, big changes happen in their world. And so part of these contracts are stages and markers for our souls to reach developmental progress, if you would call it that.
And how do we know when a contract is complete with somebody?
Well, I tell you what, there's a lot of signs that you will get in your life when something is way overdue its closure. You feel uncomfortable in your life. The relationships do not flow. There's a lot of disagreements. There's a lot of confusion around communication. You just feel like you can't even be around each other. And when you feel that place, it's as if you're holding back your own soul's growth and development. So your guides give you all these signs when a contract is complete and it's really time to move forward. And sometimes when we as souls resist that, we start to get physical symptoms of stress, illnesses, things that show us that you're holding on to something way past its blessing for you. It's opportune moment for you. And now you're just kind of milking a dead horse, if you would like to use that phrase. So when we recognize that we are starting to get uncomfortable, we're starting to push past our comfort zone, those are really the signs that the contracts are coming to completion and a leap of faith action needs to happen. It starts to feel kind of scary a little bit, and scary is actually a good thing for us as humans, because when we are able to push past these boundaries and we're able to change the contractual obligations, complete these, we really evolve and we step into places in our lives where we're really in awe. Like, I can't believe that I just did that. I can't believe this just happened. So that, I think completing contracts are also ways that we as soul reach a level of enlightenment and peace within ourselves. And that's essentially what we're here to find, is, you know, a place of peace, a place of connectedness, a place of belonging. And so these contracts are ways for us to just reach these stages and continue going on.
And how does the Akashic Records help us with these agreements, contracts, et cetera?
You know, oftentimes when people are in places in their lives where they're dealing with difficulties, whether it's with people, whether it's situations, whether they're growth momentums and they're pushing against it, when they open the Akashic Records, when you open the Akashic Records and you find out, wow, this is a soul contract that I have been dealing with for so many lifetimes, and these are the reasons why I'm experiencing these physical, emotional, mental symptoms, these are the ways I can actually get past that. And this is what I really specialize in the Akashic Records, is I really connect people to tools that they can apply on a practical level to be able to change aspects of their lives. So when you find out here's a tool, for example, such as using the water formula to be able to upgrade your vibration, to be able to do cord cutting meditations to close, cut, and release relationships and contracts, those are actual actions that we as souls can take. And when we take those actions, it allows us to be able to, it's like we take off an old coat and we have a new wardrobe ahead of us. These are new choices ahead of us. And so when we are able to go through actions, practices, rituals, ceremonies, whatever closure we need, then we are really able to be free of the baggage so that we can just be lighter as souls and do our work.
Yeah, wow. And What are some of the key themes that the Akashic Records seems to be providing insight for
people? Yeah, so I realize.
Talk about relationships. Yeah.
And I really think that it comes to five, actually. I think five key themes. And when I look at the power of numbers, five is really a numerology about change. And so when we come down here as souls, these are some of the major themes that we really face. And when we look at the word love, love is such a huge theme because it's not just the love that we share with others. It's the way we show love to ourselves, how we experience and contain and express that energy of love. I've often heard that you're only able to share as much love as you are able to give yourself love. So when you're in the Akashic Records, when we're talking about love as a major theme, that is a really, really big spectrum that is beyond just the word. It's not just a psychology, it's an emotional, it's a spiritual thing. So we look at all those factors. We also look at the factor of money. A lot of people come into this world with money karma. And a lot of that money karma is based on debt mentality, poverty mentality, and the course of that feeling not good enough and self-worth. So the third theme is based on health. Health and wealth are so intricately tied together. And when people often have these issues around money challenges, wealth isn't too far behind that because they often have stress following their lives. The fourth theme that people really, really also face are relationships and communication. A lot of these relationships are based on contracts and agreements. And so when they're replaying themselves, there's a part of them that feels like, man, this feels so familiar. I know this has happened before. Is there a different outcome? And so we try to have a different, we use our free will to choose a different outcome. And the last theme is really connected to how we see ourselves as multidimensional beings. This is a theme that I think is such a new theme coming because when we come into this plane, we awaken at so many different levels and at different times. And we are entering a time right now where this awakening and enlightening process is happening worldwide. We're picking up from the time frame of the 1850s, entering into the 1900s, which is like the new spiritual enlightenment. Well, I feel like we're also entering this new wave. And this theme is recognizing our multi-dimensional nature. What can we affect not only in this life, but also in the other scales of life? And that's a little bit more than what people want to think about, especially because, you know, one of those themes is connected to your relationship to spirit. And so this is also tied to that fifth theme of the universal being. Who are you as a universal being and your place of service in the world? Once you start thinking into that fifth theme, you have now evolved on some level of consciousness past the base instincts of survival, intimacy, sexuality, relationships, and now you've got certain aspects of your life as foundational cornerstones, and now you're able to look at that big picture of who am I, what am I here to serve, and how am I here to leave a legacy and impact? And that fifth theme is passionately drives so many people and what they do in the world.
Wow. So as we start to wrap up, before we talk more about the business council, which definitely want to, is there like one or two tangible actions that you would recommend those of us hearing and watching this to take to kind of tap into the benefits of working with the Akashic Records?
Yes, absolutely. First of all, I want you all to know that you have access to the Akashic Records in so many different ways. And your record keepers, your guides, your counsel, they're talking to you at all different times. What you have to be able to do is get quiet to be able to discern what you're hearing as guidance versus just ideas running through your mind. What I encourage people to do is actually set a time once a day, once a week, even just 20 minutes to get quiet and to, instead of going into their head and getting lost in their thoughts, actually grounding into their center of their being to be able to just separate themselves separate yourself from the external world to just really be in what I call your sacred heart space. So you can be in the silence to listen. And then when you're in the silence, this is when you can bring questions to your guides and say, can you help me with this? I have a question about my work. I have a question about this friendship. Could you give me some guidance? And you'll be so surprised by what you receive in that silence. The second thing I encourage you to do is bring a little journal, a little notebook with you, you know, something like this. And you can carry a little notebook around with you, because when you're tapped in, you're constantly getting a stream of ideas. And if you realize that the ideas that they're shown to you are the ones that you really need to focus on, it cuts all the other distraction of what you need to do. So creating space and time shows your guides you are interested in connecting. Carrying around a notebook, being open to what shows up in your dreams and your thoughts, that's another way to be able to receive. And I think, honestly, ask for the questions. And when you ask, you're really asking Source. And the Akashic Records is essentially the library of Source. So when you ask, you will receive that information.
Mm. Beautiful. So for those who are interested in working with you, of course, you provide one-on-one, I assume you provide one-on-one work with those who are interested. Mm-hmm. But let's just talk for a few minutes about your newest offer, which is the Akashic Business Council. So tell us about that.
So this is a tool that was a method that was really developed because I took part in this coaching program this year, George, with you. And I was so inspired by all of these business owners around me. And because I was listening to what the record keepers were trying to show me, I asked them at the beginning of the year, what do you think is the most valuable thing I could bring to this community that could help them out? And they said, show them how to connect to your Akashic Record Business Council. And really, this is your council of guides who are here to help you with your work so you can be successful. And they really focus on the three things that business owners really need to have, which is success in their business, client flow, and money flow. And so this is what I was shown to be able to share with this community and share with the world, because as a group, as business owners, we're here to succeed. And we are inundated with so much information that sometimes we just need counsel to give us some clarity on what direction to take, what information to work with, who to work with, how much to take on, and when it's time to rest. Because I've really learned the value of rest this year from working with this community. So I find that working with your business council helps you to be able to get key ideas that you can actually take action on and generate an outcome.
Yeah, and it's very affordable. The product that you have right now as of this recording, it's only $37.
Absolutely,
right? And
absolutely.
It is it includes, I think, a video, an audio meditation, a written guide that helps the person who has these things to connect with their own Akashic Record Business Council. And so it's a very empowering tool, and it's a great deal. I recommend it. So if you, those of you watching this, I'm sure there's a link below or connected to the video where you can go and check it out. Anything else you want to say about that?
You know, when you go into the Akashic Business Council meeting, you want to be prepared. And think of it like a professional business meeting. Like when I have meetings with people, I prepare myself. I dress up. I have questions ready. I make it a big deal. So when I call in my guides and counsel, I like to have a certain direction, a certain focus, like what kind of things should I do on a financial level? In terms of marketing, how much should I invest in advertising? In terms of my website, what are the top two or three things I need to focus on? In terms of my clients, who are the top five I should call first this week? So having very focused questions will really help your guide to lead you to the direction that you want to do or reach, which is growth and success. And I think this is the most important aspect too, is when you ask your guides for suggestions and for help, don't doubt the help that you get. When you get this suggestion to take action, you have literally a less than a 10 second window before that genius idea starts to dissipate in energy and form and in thought. And so when you receive this guidance, act on it, because this is really the pavement. These are the stepping stones that lead you to the outcome of your, what I call your dream life.
Wow, wonderful. Well, I hope those watching, if you're interested, go and sign up for this this training on accessing your Akashic Record Business Council. And if you have any questions, comment below the video. I'll make sure Anne sees it. And of course, I'll include Anne's website as well and the Facebook page. And you can reach out to her for any additional guidance and information about her services. Anne, thank you so much for doing this interview and for sharing and teaching us today about the Akashic Records.
Absolutely. I'm so happy to be able to share this message with you. It's working in the Akashic Records that completely changed my life. Every day I'm like, my mind is blown because I think, wow, this is the work I get to do with the world. And it feels like play. And it is so enriching. And I'm so grateful to be able to share this with you, because there are beings, there are guides, there are angels, there are loved ones and masters who are really waiting to work with you. And they're really ready to help you take that load of stress off your shoulders, to help you feel like you're not doing this alone. So thank you, George.
Thank you so much. All right. Well, folks, go ahead and use the links below to follow up and check it out. All right. See you in the next video. Bye, everyone.
Bye.